My name is Cora, I'm from SK Danceport, and today I'm going to give you guys a tutorial on how to do this beautiful, gorgeous updo for standard. This is specifically for standard or smooth. You don't really want to do a style like this for Latin or rhythm, it's just too elaborate for that style. But for standard and smooth, it's perfect, especially if, like my beautiful assistant here, Masha, especially if your partner is considerably taller than you. So Masha and her partner, Antosha, have a pretty big height difference. How much is it? Seven inches. About 7 inch height difference, which is pretty considerable. So in that case, we normally want to put the hair more on the top of the head for the girls so that it gives them a little bit more height. So that's what I'm going to show you guys today. I'm going to take you through it step by step. If you like it, please remember to subscribe. You can subscribe by getting the little button down there. All right, we'll go through it one by one. Also in the description, you can find a link to the website where I'll have an entire list of supplies where you can buy them and a few other little tips that you can see in there. Remember to subscribe and we will be back with you guys later.
Thank you.
Now, they're a little bit difficult sometimes to do. What we generally do is we just use school glue. Again, in the website, on the blog post, you'll see the link to school glue. I'll have a link to the exact one that I use so that you can buy it. You don't have to go searching for it. What you do is you want to just do a little dab of school glue wherever you want to place the stone. I'm doing it right on this area right here where the hair goes in so that we accentuate the shape of the hair. The other cool thing about rhinestones that you can do is you can use the rhinestones to cover up some messy parts. So actually, Maria's hair is looking pretty good. I don't have too many messy parts, but you might have a few when you're doing it for the first time yourself. So then we can take those rhinestones, you can put them in the middle, right there, as you can see, to accentuate the little circle. You can put them off on the side here, there. You can put them actually in the hair, but like I said, the way that I attach them is by using school glue. You put the dab on, use the hair dryer to blow dry a little bit so that it's a little bit dry. You don't want to put the stones on it absolutely wet, because then it's going to be quite difficult for the stones to stick. So you want to dry off the glue just a little bit, and then just stick those stones in there. And again, we use it to accentuate the style that we've created here. Yeah? The other place where you can put the stones is on the back. In this particular case, because it's a nice soft brown style in the back here, I wouldn't put any rhinestones back here, but you can certainly put rhinestones here. You see where the curves have come in and then out. If we look at the other side, you can put the rhinestones in. I would probably do most of the rhinestones on this side because this is the more intricate side of the hair. So what I really want to do is I want to accentuate every single place where there's a curve like this, so that when we see the hair from far away, it's really obvious. Make sure that you buy a few extra rhinestones that go with your dress. So in this case, Masha's dress has these crystal AB stones, so she has extra of them and it matches her dress right away. No matter what color your dress is, just remember to get extra stones in that color so that you can put the rhinestones on to match your dress.